sunshine. My one solution is my queen, cause she's this strong. Yeah, yeah. She is always in my corner, right there when I wanna. All these other girls are tempting, but I'm empty when you're gone. And they say, do you need me? Do you think I'm pretend? Do I make you feel like cheating? I'm like, no, not really, cause oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader.
Probably being in all the shows and the concerts and just having a laugh during them.
Nice. Always.
The shows are pretty good.
I don't think I have a distinct favourite memory. It is generally just being with everyone. Yeah, like there are some funny ones. Like when me and Brooke hid under tables
before lockdown
in the dock and absolutely freaked Mr. Burton out and he absolutely jumped out of his skin. I've not seen anything like it. They're just funny things that people have done.
I quite like disrupting the blue room.
That was
such a because like we all signed bricks.
Yeah, we all signed our names.
We didn't disrupt.
And then your cousin wrote his Instagram name
all over.
Yeah.
That was quite fun.
When we would play Uno and Chi and lots of other card games on Friday afternoons and at lunchtime.
When we were at bottle flipping in year 12 and Mr. Benesh just came in and yelled at like three specific people to get out of the room and not the rest of us.
Did you have to go?
Because we were flipping it onto like the top of the windows.
Yeah, that was really fun until it got ruined.
When Amy tripped over Mr. Nichols and smashed her head on the door. I wouldn't even know, but that's my favourite.
Probably when Miss Sutton comes in every single day to tell us off for talking in the common room.
True.
Starting year 12.
Yeah. Dedicating our corner and playing card games.
That was our corner.
That was.
There's a lot of
feeding
involved.
One lunchtime, when we were allowed the microwave, I had brought in a shepherd's pie for lunch. And I knew that Brooke had salt in her locker. So me and Phoebe went up and was like, Brooke, can I like borrow some salt, please? Well, not borrow it, because, you know. And then she was like, yeah, of course. Now Phoebe shook it and the whole lid came off and went all over my shepherd's pie, completely ruined my lunch.
A whole pot of salt.
I still owe Brooke a pot of salt.
Our A-level drama class, I really loved being with Miss Reed and Miss Little, messing around, doing some warm-ups.
Rehearsals like, for devising.
Yeah, stretching our hips awkwardly and then random teachers walk in and it's really awkward.
Yeah.
Back when we had good food in the canteen and we had very nice biscuits and good unhealthy food. I don't have any memories.
Says a favourite school memory would be something major, but I think it's just as little as playing football at lunchtime and laughing. Actually, Amsterdam with this girl, favourite memory.
Yeah.
100%.
Scrap all that, bit.
Scrap all that. Amsterdam with this girl was amazing. I loved every moment
so
of it.
Amsterdam was so good. But playing football at lunchtime is so good.
It's my favourite time of the day, honestly.
My favourite's probably in geography during our live lesson. We all held up hanky letters for Miss McGill because she was struggling with it.
Our first maths live lesson, everyone joined in the wrong link and then Dylan started playing the circle song. That was funny.
Making marshmallow castles.
Well, I
with Miss Landy.
Yeah.
All our sweets. What did we make? Hampton Court with Queen Elizabeth as a gummy bear.
That's a good
one. She was pretty good.
I bet she was tasty. So another memory was when we all kind of came back after, was it the first lockdown?
Yeah.
So we hadn't seen each other for months and we all just started playing football together.
And it's really nice.
Really nice.
Yeah.
Really nice. And then
we started going against boys, didn't we? And who won?
Girls.
Got to see who was the really competitive people.
Oh, we know. Some of the people were a bit scary during those football games.
Definitely the boys at the back of the boys at the back of Miss Raseem's class. Oh wee, we got up to some stupid. When I jumped off the top ropes onto the top of Tom's head.
Yeah, no, that was funny.
Cracked his head open.
Yeah,
that was fun. Out
of time. Yes, the time I walked out in PE without shorts on. Just my thermals. So everyone was laughing at me. It wasn't very nice.
I think one time in year 10, I was in front of like half a PE class and I tried to bunny hop a bin. I just got caught in it and did a front flip onto the ground in front of everybody. So yeah, that was nice.
Oh no.
When Mr. Burton walked in on us filming a TikTok.
Your shoes off because you ain't going home now.
I think my most embarrassing moment was in year 9.
No.
Or year 8. I fancied a boy called Joe Devine in our school. And in PE, I went up to him and I said, are we linking? And he said no, and I cried. I think that's the most embarrassing moment.
Aww.
But I get really easy embarrassed, so it could be so many.
When in year 7, as a young boy, we went to the swimming carver. I had to do backstroke. It was like 2 lengths. And I did 1 length, then I got out of the pool, took my goggles and my hat off, walked around to the side. Everyone started yelling at me, oh, you gotta go do another lap. And I was like, oh no.
Oh no.
And I had to go jump back into the pool with everyone watching me and yeah, so yeah.
I was in drama class with Mr. Kerr as well, and my brother came in and started harassing me, and Mr. Kerr as well pulled me aside and said, do you need me to sort him out? Is he bullying you? Because he didn't know he was my brother.
Oh, yeah. In year 11, in computing, I went to go sit down on my chair, and I didn't look behind me, and behind me Tom Blythe pulled my chair away from me and it ended up on the floor. Like, I just didn't realise that was quite embarrassing.
Probably when I started laughing in the biology test, that was quite bad. It was also quite funny, because the question was funny.
Completely silent and Abigail just starts laughing.
Yeah, it's my stupid sense of humour. You're a star of the show.
Another geography one, but I was in geography doing my bachelor in year 7s, and then my phone goes off and it's really loud, and Miss McGill thinks it's one of the year 7s, so I just have to awkwardly say it was my phone.
When I threw up in art, when I threw up in drama.
I don't know if it's embarrassing, but when I was in like year 7, we were doing that the history thing with the tortoise and the shields, and Liam George pelted a beanbag right into my eyeball.
Oh my god.
And that really hurt. And I didn't have any friends at that point as well, so it was just really awkward.
I got one about Brooke when in year 9 when it was called Andy's Coming, like that challenge, wasn't it? No?
Yeah.
Oh, what,
yeah, when everyone drops.
Yeah, we were in year 9 maths and Miss Carol was out of the room and Cameron said, when I cough, when she comes back in, everyone dropped. And we all did it. But Brooke, it was all silent. And Brooke hit her head. And the radiant's really hot.
In year 7, going into even like a year 8 class.
That's so awkward.
Oh, don't. I went in and then one of the girls was bent over. And then I ran in, smacked her on the bum thinking it was Alice. And I looked up, realised it was a class full of year 8s and just darted out.
You didn't say anything.
In front of all of them were staring at me. I've just hit this girl's bum.
In year 11 biology, we were dissecting, I think it was sheep eyes, and I couldn't like get the scalpel in it because it was really tough. So Miss Wilson came like on the other side of the bench and I had my hair dangling down like as she was doing it, and she just stabbed it and then all of the juice went straight into my hair. And then she took me to the back of the classroom and I had to bend over the sink and she had to wash it out in front of my whole class.
Well, mine is probably when I was trying to take Instagram photos at the bus stop and the bus just drove directly past me and we missed the bus. Bearing in mind we waited a whole hour to get this bus and then it just drove past us.
Mine was probably when I was like sitting on the bench and then like a ball just like yeeted me in the head.
He was concussed.
And it was like in the middle of everyone, it was just so awkward.
He was concussed for the whole day.
You were.
On Leavers Day in year 11, Miss Carol was signing Stephen's t-shirt and so he was holding her ice cream for her, and then I came and licked it thinking it was Stephen's and it wasn't. And she doesn't know, this will probably be her finding out.
Oh god, that's so embarrassing.
Every day is embarrassing when you're me. I tripped over several tables in my time, but yeah, that's about it.
I fall over all the time. And Jade pushes the bed.
You can't sit on
those. She also slipped over in the toilet.
I landed like on one knee and it was like I was proposing to Maya, but I slipped. But yeah, Jade pushed me off the bench and then I was stuck on my back like a turtle and I couldn't move.
Bad things, it's a lot of bad things that they wishing and wishing and wishing and wishing they wishing on me. Yeah. Yeah. Bad things, it's a lot of bad things that they wishing and wishing and wishing and wishing they wishing on me. Yeah. Thank you.
Saffron.
There you go.
Phoebe and Jade or Phoebe and Larissa?
Yeah.
It's like Tom and Jerry.
Definitely. Oh my goodness, it actually is.
Oh,
I lost. End of. End.
Pretty dynamic.
Oh, Miss Mabs and Miss K. They were the best.
They were cute.
You
and Abigail?
I don't know.
I
think
Ellie and Grace are
better. Miss Landy and Mr. Nickel.
Oh, they're so cute.
Yeah.
Love them.
Mr. Nickel and Miss Landy.
Charlie and Phoebe.
Charlie and Ethan, I guess.
Oh my god.
Charlie and Ethan. They're like the best, they're like the definition of frenemies.
Who?
Charlie and Ethan.
Mr. Holmes
and
Mr. Burton, yeah, definitely.
I feel like they're our dads and we're all their adopted kids.
Honestly.
Yeah.
And Miss Sutton's like the aunt or something.
She's just the crazy aunt that
looks after everyone.
Oh, bless
her.
She's
the
babysitter.
Honestly,
the
aunt is just all the drama, having to cope with all the
nuts.
Billionaire in, I think they're so cute.
Yeah.
Billionaire in.
Yeah.
Stuck to going all the way through.
That's true. You and Saffron share?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hanging out by the office all the time?
That's not by choice.
You mean India best job? In year 7. Try it, any girl.
I feel like everyone's gonna have to say Marcy for this.
Do you?
Oh, no, sorry. I was gonna say Brooke and Tom Bly. It lasted a long time.
How long was it?
2.5 years.
Solid.
Young
What year?
79. That one relationship has lasted 3 years. Well done, Donnie.
Thank you. The best couple is Holly and
Dylan. Ella and Kirsty.
Well, of course you would say that.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I can't think of any.
Matthew and Sean
was always good.
Butcher and Johnny.
Holly and Dylan are going to win the best couple, but when we're talking about the five-year couples, longest lasting couple is probably like Brooke and Tom.
That's funny.
I
guess that's a couple, Dylan and Holly.
Me and Niall are pretty funny. Yeah. Or me and Vic. That's a power couple.
I mean, me and Dylan are better.
All we
Jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. I lived. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up. And when that sun goes down, hope you raise your cup. Oh, I wish that I could witness all your joy and all your pain. But until my moment comes, I'll say I live.
Berlin. Miss Landy and her big rucksack just trolling around the place. That was funny.
Berlin.
Yeah, probably Berlin.
It was great.
Berlin.
Berlin, of course.
A lot of stuff went down there.
Yeah.
Stuff that we do not speak of.
Yeah.
Amsterdam.
Berlin.
Cromer.
Berlin.
Why do you say it then too?
Yeah, Amsterdam.
Yeah, Berlin.
That was a good trip.
Amsterdam.
Berlin was pretty good, but it was like not good at the same time. So I'd say Amsterdam.
Luckily, we got to go to Amsterdam just before, so literally just
all the lockdown.
Yeah,
yeah.
But it was a good trip.
Such a good trip. My favorite trip was Berlin. Just loved it.
Really enjoyed both trips, to be honest.
Yeah.
Because I feel like we weren't really meant to go on them, were we? Just kind of. Mr. was like, oh, can tag
yeah,
along.
There were free spaces,
and
so we just
we went
came.
To, like, the Curious Incident, Charlie the Chocolate Factory.
Yeah,
it was
good.
Really fun. A good opportunity.
My favourite school trip was the A-level drama trip to watch Solaris. Very hilarious.
There's been some quite good theatre ones.
Hey,
explain.
The cheese wraps with the ham and the tomato sauce.
We used to have like a, like, we always used to have like coffee and stuff at the beginning of year 12.
Oh, coffee basket.
Just seeing my friends every day, not to get emotional, guys, but it is what it is.
I miss your 11 science lessons.
Yeah,
that's my
favourite. Oh, and geography lessons, they're good.
Yeah. GCSE business, it's pretty funny as well.
I think I'm just going to miss the laughs.
Just really being together. Yeah. We're never really going to get an opportunity again to
be
this close.
Yeah, definitely.
Such a long time.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
Not gonna be.
Just coming in and seeing Miss Sutton and listening to all her stories and all her wisdom.
Yeah.
Not having had to cope with all of our drama.
Yeah.
Who's gonna defuse the situation?
Who's gonna put my blister plasters on for me?
Yeah. Who's gonna make me a coffee and a hot water bottle?
I'm gonna miss like annoying everyone.
I won't.
The boys.
Yeah, probably the boys.
Yeah, the
Nothing
boys.
Else really.
The boys?
The boys. The boys. And nothing but the boys.
I miss the deer.
Oh,
he is one of the boys.
No,
he is one of the boys.
He is
one of the boys.
He is
one of the boys.
I miss the deer.
The staff. And a few of my classmates. Nice teachers. And we just like sit in the common room and just.
Yeah, just chilling.
Like
eating loads. We buy so much food and just eat it all in here.
Yeah.
Ordering our takeaways, Chinese, everything's sitting here.
Literally just my like, I'm so glad.
No, stop it.
I will miss this girl the most.
I'll miss you.
I'll miss her the most. 100%. Well, in school in general, like every single year, the memories, like, you can't, like, already now thinking about school, I'm like, I don't want to leave school. Like,
yeah.
I want to go back to year 8,
it is
back
just
to
those
year
small
9.
Things.
And, like, it was just so fun.
We've got a good bunch of teachers.
Yeah, yeah. Definitely, and teachers.
I'm scared we buy that rock. I don't want to leave.
I feel like because
I'm waiting at the gates.
Yeah, because of lockdown and everything, I feel like we've missed last year, so it's like we are not ready to leave. It doesn't feel like, I feel like we're still in March of year 12.
I miss being able to just be stupid.
You'll still be stupid.
Yeah, I was going to say.
You'll find someone to be stupid with.
There'll be more repercussions then.
I think seeing my friends every day, that's going to be like a real weird change because when I moved up from primary to secondary, I didn't really change friendship groups, I just stayed in the same group.
We all came with you.
Yeah, dragged you with me.
No,
yeah, I think just seeing them every day will be a bit strange.
Also the teachers, we've got them for the whole group, I feel, most of them.
Yeah.
The people.
Yeah.
The friends.
Just being with everyone all the time. Yeah.
Friends.
Yeah, the people.
The people. And the teachers.
Yeah, and the teachers. Just positive vibes around.
I'm so thankful for the moment. So glad I got to know you. The times that we had, I'll keep like the photograph. And hold you in my heart forever. I'll chapter in the book, can't go back, but you can look, and there we are on every page, memories I'll always save, up ahead only open doors, who knows what we're heading towards, I wish you love, for you the world just opens up. Time's that we had, I'll keep like a photograph.
This is my most embarrassing moment.